Madam, a small feedback.
Yes, sir.
Your Jupyter notebook is less than 40% only visible. Majority of the screen on the right side, all the participants are coming. On the top, there's a big band which is blank.
Yeah, actually, they supposed to change, I think so, Professor Ramesh Pandey, because my end I may not able to do, sir. For me, it is visible, like I need to work on two window. One window is to look at the chat box and participants and my face. Other window is to work with Jupyter Notebook. Microsoft Teams and Google Meet both working like that. Professor Pandey, I request you to zoom that Jupyter Notebook portion. If something is possible to zoom, you can zoom out.
Okay, actually today I'm not the admin.
Okay.
One of my first-year students, he prepared this Zoom, sorry, Google
Yeah,
Meet.
you can pass on the message to that student. Otherwise, no, it
Okay.
occupies
Yes.
all the logos of the participant and the chat box. These two only predominantly visible. That particular notebook which I'm sharing is very miniature. Yeah, that is the reason the effectiveness may go. At least either visual should be perfect or audio should be perfect. Otherwise, the learning would become very difficult. I'm just a presenter. I'm not having that control. So kindly request who is the owner of this link for today's link to change the mode of presentation to maximize so that people will get benefit of what is there in the notebook. Otherwise, it is very tedious. The whole purpose, at least the visual should go better. It should not be very miniature. Tomorrow onwards, I wanted to create the link. That is the reason I said I wanted to create the link.
Yeah, that
Or
will
we
be
need
fine,
to,
ma'am.
yeah.
Actually, starting from yesterday, same screen is visible, means bandwidth,
Yeah, that actually,
Today,
that
we
window
continue
mode,
like
it
this.
is possible. It is possible.
Okay,
The
ma'am.
window mode we need to change.
Okay, anyway, ma'am. We may continue the session.
Okay, sir. Yeah, I just good evening, guys, all of you. Let me start with the yesterday's discussion. In order to run the cell, we need to start with either pressing shift and enter or press run button. If you want to convert particular cell as a text, then either you can use heading or markdown. If you want to code with the Python, then you need to use code. This is the option. So these are all the four options, sir. So because of this Jupyter Notebook, at time it is not even necessary to use a single line comment, multi-line comment. Instead, we can change the cell, particular cell into either markdown cell or heading cell. So this is the advantage. So we looked into IDE, Google Collaboratory. I suggest for all of you, since most of you are using only the mobile or may not be comfortable in installing, so that it is better. Google Collaboratory is better for always to execute this kind of code, small pieces of code. Today evening, the moment WhatsApp group is formed, I will share this notebook in the WhatsApp group as well as with the Professor Ramesh, so that you can get to know the same notebook. You can practice for your exercises. Then this is what, instead of if you want to bring an image, then you need to code HTML code, a small tagline, that's all. A small tag, it is called IMG. That tag of HTML you need to bring here. You need to mention a source of the file, width and height, so that I don't want to maintain two presentation, one with Microsoft PowerPoint and one with Jupyter Notebook. Instead, I want to combine only the Jupyter Notebook as a presentation medium as well as a coding platform. Now we started discussing who invented or who brought the compiler for Python. So that's what discussed. Then all the theory properties we discussed. Subsequently, we started with a single line comment and a multi-line comment. Then we moved on to variable creation, with the variable creation, multiple assignment. We have created three variable simultaneously in a single line. We tried assigning more than one value for each and every variable correspondingly. One-to-one association. Age will take the first value, name will take the second value, city would take the third value. Then we started printing this. This is possible only to print with the Jupyter notebook. Just giving the variable name, it displays for us the value. When we start working with Python shell, Python core Python IDE, then it is not possible. As one of you mentioned that why can't you use print, something like that yesterday. It is mandatory to use print function. Without print, it is not possible to print in other environment. Only in the Jupyter notebook it is possible to print just by telling the name of the variable. That is a point we may need to remember. Then subsequently we moved on. Anything which we create in Jupyter notebook, any kind of variable, any kind of identifiers we create, everything would be treated as object. That is why it is termed as object-oriented programming. But compared to C++, Java, here we no need to mention whether really we are creating class or object. Automatically, it converts all the instances, whatever we are creating, in terms of object. So if you look at if city or age, type of age, type function will help us to find out data type of the variable age. Already I mentioned the very big advantage of Python is we no need to mention data type for each and every variable. The moment I started giving 43, it started assigning the value 43 to age. Suppose one more I'm going to bring. Weight, I'm going to give 65.7. This is what really exactly my age, my weight. So I'm going to press this. Now what would happen? Weight will be assigned with the float value. City will be assigned with Hyderabad. Name will be assigned with Lakshmi. Age will be assigned with 43. So this is what. Then gender, another variable, gender. And now I'm going to give in a single quote or double quote. I can give both either in single quote or double quote. A single character only I'm giving. Although I give single character, it will be treated as a string data type or character data type, this gender. Now double, I can assign the value either with single quote or I can assign the value with a double quote. For your differentiation, I'm going to give, see, look at this. I'm giving Lakshmi in single quote, Hyderabad in double quotes. So it's both are valid and well accepted for the string representation or string assignment in the case of Python. Now I'm just asking to give the value which is available in age. So it prints 43. Next I'm asking the variable name, it gives the value Lakshmi. Then I am asking the value of city, then it gives Hyderabad. Hydration, it gives Hyderabad. Somehow it is moved on to hydration, so it gives Hyderabad. So now age is ready, name is ready, city, the updated value will come. Now type of age is int, type of name is str, type of city is str. Now I will ask you one question. What would be type of weight? Could anyone able to guess type of weight and could answer to me?
And float.
Yeah. So float. Now similarly, I'm going to give type of what else? Gender. STR. Although I assigned a single character F, it gives me str. This particular assignment is also str. This assignment is also str. Although I am using only one character, this is also treated as str. Str stands for string. So these are all the foundation we may need to understand before getting into the deeper level. A, B equal, C equal to 25. It is multiple variable assigned with single value. This is what one of the student raised the question, how to assign single value in multiple variables. So this concept also we have covered. Then operators, arithmetic operators, because many of you have joined today, so that I'm giving quick revision. These all yesterday we have covered. When it comes to today's point of discussion, I'll go slower. So these are all the possible arithmetic operators we have discussed. So this first is addition. All of us know from the childhood we are doing subtraction, multiplication, division. This modulo symbol we may need to understand. The difference between division and the modulo symbol, only the question mark. We need to understand. This is for exponentiation. What is exponentiation? 2 to the power of 10, 10 to the power of 5, 5 to the power of 8. Anything which we want to find out the power of, the power function, it is equivalent to power function. So this division will give us quotient of the division of two number. This percentage symbol, modulo operator, will give us remainder of the division process. What is the meaning of remainder is 5, if we try to divide by 2, 2 times it will go. After 2 times, the remainder would become 1. That remainder only we are getting. See, if rather, if you try to give below 2 modulo 5, if the numerator is lesser than the denominator, the result would become only the numerator. Because not even single time we can divide. It won't go 2 divided by 5. Without a fractional point, we need to immediately use fractional point. Then 2 need to be appended with 0. Then it would become 20. Then 0.4 would become your answer. So it is not possible whenever we use remainder without that decimal point. How we can obtain the division operation? In that division operation process, the remainder is given. When the numerator becomes greater than the denominator, then you would be getting without the decimal point. If the numerator is lesser than the denominator, the numerator itself would be the answer. Now 5 to the power of 2, this is power function. So this 5 to the power of 2, then you would be getting 25. So this is again exponential function. 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 4. This is what you are getting. Here the point what I want to emphasize here is, when all the operator involved in the expression becomes the same or equal precedence, we need to consider the associativity. We are considering here left to right associativity. The meaning is the evaluation would be starting from the left direction, left extreme of the expression. 2 to the power of 2 is first executed. The result which we obtain, that result is going to be raised with the power 4. So that is called left to right associativity. The direction of evaluation will become the matter when all the operators are of equal precedence, all the operators are of the same kind, then direction is the matter. Now, when it comes data science, then these are all the topic of discussion would be coming. I have around 20 more websites for downloading the data. Whenever we want to work on even mechanical engineering, lot of data set available, industry related data, manufacturing data, fault anomaly detection data, leakage detection data. If you go to these kind of websites, you will be getting the data set. Then you can attempt or analyze the data set. You can even write a paper or you can submit it as a project. So for that, data is mandatory in order to get the data. Or else we need to work on real-time data or real-time project. We need to acquire the data, either IoT or in terms of any kind of observation. We need to automation. We need to observe the data. Then we can go with the project or we can do analysis. If we don't have such kind of project, then we can look at this kind of existing website, wherein which they will be giving the data set of 70 rows, 15 rows, or 1000 rows, 1 lakh rows, and 10 columns, depending upon the data set and its distribution. That slowly I'll be touching upon, nothing to worry. We can download those data sets. We can proceed with our research publication or project, something like that. So for that, you can look at, always you can type even in the Google, manufacturing data, industry data set, IoT data set. These kind of data set even you can generate, you can pull out and you can start doing analysis and you can submit it as a project or whatever you want. So for that, I'm just starting to introduce here right now, Kaggle, GitHub, UCA, machine learning repositories. I will explain one by one. Kaggle is a website. Just type Kaggle and it will take you to Kaggle. Kaggle, the specialty is, quite often Kaggle would be conducting competitions on machine learning and deep learning. These are all the two domain. Most of the time, Kaggle would be conducting competitions. Then best award winners, it will research, it will publishize, and it will give lot of job avenues, and it will give lot of laurels, like a badge designations. It will be given that you are Kaggle star, something like that. So that kind of motivation we can get it from Kaggle. So lot of competition people used to launch. Every weekly ones also, sometime it would be there, monthly ones also it would be there. Lot of revenue, kind of revenue generation aspect also you can think of, not only enriching your knowledge. Initial period you can enrich. Subsequently, through Kaggle problem solution, you can form a team. That team could be your own team, or you can form a team across the globe. You can pick the person and you can send the proposal. Then if they accept, you can form a team. Then in your teammates, you can solve the problem and submit the solution. Another advantage, Kaggle has a lot of data set. Along with the data set, coding also will be available. For example, top winner coding and whomever takes part in the Kaggle competition, everybody's coding will be released on the Kaggle itself. So that is an added advantage. We can able to learn things from the winners of that particular problem domain, who have provided the solution to the problem domain. The top winners also we can look at, we can learn from them, how they are analyzing the data, in what angle they are cleaning the data, lot of parameters we can take as an input. So that is another kind of learning. Kaggle itself hosts lot of mini courses for free. Related to machine learning, deep learning and data science. Data science is a subset of machine learning. That's it. Again, deep learning is also a subset of machine learning. That's it. So nothing to worry. Slightly the concepts and the way of training the machine, way of building the algorithm would become different for each terminology. But at the outset, all are same. Data science, machine learning, deep learning, all are same. Even in deep learning, data only input, predominant input to the model. So that terminology convention, no need to worry. Boldly you can say, all are interchangeably same also you can say. Deep learning, machine learning, data analytics, all are interchangeably same. If you really become a technical techie guy, then you can think of the exact or appropriate definition. In the being the beginner, no need to worry of the terminologies or buzzwords. So this is the introduction about Kaggle. You can sign up with Kaggle. Kaggle is also the platform of Google. Google's platform only, Google Collaboratory, Google's platform only, this Kaggle. So if you have Gmail account, more than enough. Easily you can sign in with Gmail account. No need of subscription, no need of sign up. That all those headache is not available. You can directly log in. One step process, that's it. Then next, GitHub. GitHub is also a repository. These two platform has artificial intelligence by itself. Kaggle and GitHub. That later on you can explore what is that. Now, GitHub has plenty of data set and projects. Not only for machine learning, deep learning. Even if you want to develop a mobile app, you can find a complete end-to-end solution in the GitHub. Then with the GitHub, you can communicate with that coder who have coded. If you get stuck up, if you are not able to understand particular snippet of that notebook, you can, that everywhere the people used to call it as a notebook. Now I am also calling Jupyter notebook. I am explaining with the Jupyter notebook only. You can keep communicating with those kind of coders and you can build your expertise. So that is the advantage of GitHub. GitHub has varied kind of projects, not only machine learning, deep learning. It has plenty, even Java, Python, data structure, electronics related, varied kind of, but it is also a coding platform. And another thing I will tell you, Kaggle and GitHub, whenever we create a repository, whenever we create our coding with our own innovativeness, our own expertise, then we will be getting score. That score calculation only carried out by the artificial intelligence machine learning software. That it is inbuilt of that platforms. So through that also, there are lot of employers looking at people who have highest rank, and they themselves will give you an opportunity or interview call, or they would be picking you for the job opportunities. So those two platforms directly, it will take us to the job avenues and opportunities. OCI machine learning repository in which I can say I am firmly, I can say that manufacturing data and industry related data repository is available. If I want to solve manufacturing data, industry related data, little bit I should have the domain expertise. So that mostly I used to go with healthcare data or whichever the domain I know. Whenever we become data scientists, the very big knowledge what we should have is domain expertise. If you are working for agriculture data, we should know quite a little amount of information, a little amount of adequate knowledge we should have related to agriculture domain. If you are looking at healthcare data, which kind of data we are looking at? Lung cancer or brain cancer or what kind of data we are looking at? That related to that disease, we should have certain amount of information or knowledge. Only then data analyst job would become much more productive and meaningful. Raw, looking at raw data alone will not fulfill the exploration of the data or modeling the data or prediction of the data. So number one, domain expertise. Number two, mathematical expertise, a little bit of statistics, little bit of calculus. These two are more than enough. Then probability, three component it is expected. Probability, statistics and the calculus. Number three, coding. We need to code. It is only with the programming language only we can communicate with the machine. So there is no other way. We cannot use any other medium to communicate with the laptops or electronic devices. So that we need to be thorough on any one of the language. For the domain expertise, machine learning, deep learning, the best choice is Python. So that the same Python you can use it for even web development. Same Python you can use it for hardware projects. Like yesterday I mentioned drone applications and robotic applications. So these kind of projects are embedded application. Most of the devices comes with the embedded logic. Like a washing machine, every washing machine has its own a tiny program fixed within that device. So that is called embedded logic. So that kind of program easily we can do with Python. So that whenever you go to UCA machine learning repository, find out your domain expertise data first, where you are already familiar with. That is the data you need to touch upon first. It varies from person to person. So one of you may be good at financial data. One of you may be good at airline dynamic price fixing data. If you are familiar with that data, we can look at first. Domain familiarity is required. The data familiarity, you need to pull the data from the online website whenever the data is given with the description. If there is no description, don't touch the data because we will finally mess up with interpretation. So every column, every row, the detail, how that data is generated, what is the source, how it had arrived, that all the kind of description people will be uploading all along with the data. So we need to find out data with description. Domain expertise, data understanding is second. Only then you need to think of mathematical aspects, you need to think of programming aspect. So this is the step or order. Then after this four expertise, the fourth expertise is storytelling. It has a lot of other subdivision, but majorly I'm telling, explaining. Number one, domain expertise. We need to have that domain. If it is agricultural domain, we should know A to Z of that agricultural domain some extent. Similarly, if we look at banking domain, banking sector, we should know A to Z of banking sector. If I look at manufacturing data set, then I should have adequate knowledge in the manufacturing sector. Then after the domain expertise, understanding of the data or description. I said description. Although we know that domain, we recover description, knowledge about the data, what each and every point says. There is a proverb, data is ready to speak with you. Are you ready to listen? This is a proverb. It's a modern proverb. This is the proverb. Every data point is ready to speak with you. After that, adequate, not no need to be too much of expertise. Adequate knowledge in statistics, probability, calculus. This is expected. Fourth point, program. Programming language. Any language. Python is one of the language. R is yet another language. SAS is another method. Java we can do. MATLAB also supports. Julia. These are all the languages supports machine learning or deep learning or data analytics. Then fifth expertise, what is expected is interpretation. That is called business language. We need to translate machine learning predictions into business language or human languages. In any language, we need to speak, no, in order to run the business, in order to make the profit of the business. See, I'm keeping this entire seller's code. That is why this green color, everything comes. I need to completely change it to Markdown. Only then it changes. Because it's completely related to textual information. I'm articulating, narrating. These are all the required guidelines to become the data scientist. Nothing more else. Then when it comes, modeling, combining these two together or these three together, then lot of steps we need to discuss about it. That we will look at later. Now, these are all the major websites. There are plenty more. Even Indian websites, the Indian YouTube channels, they are articulating very well in Indian, suitable for Indian language, accent and many more things. When we look at the most of the Westerner video, that accent would be the problem. When we watch our Indian native speakers video, we may feel ace with language, rather we can focus on the intellectual stuff. So we would not be getting any. And Amuda Shiva, please mute yourself. Amuda Shiva.
Ma'am, can you share the screen? We are not able to see us.
Yeah, already I shared, na? 1 minute I'll try. Yeah, once again I'll try. Already I shared. Once again I'll try. Yeah, that's it. We stopped at this point. These are all the five steps every data scientist need to follow. It is required. Coming to that, online ID we discussed. Google Colab is the best solution. Either if you don't have laptop or if you are not adequate or comfortable in installation, you can directly go with Google Colab. Kaggle Notebook. Kaggle Notebook also works like a Google Colab. It is another online ID. Directly you can upload the notebook into Google Kaggle and you can download. It is vice versa. All the three interrelated. Google Collaboratory, Kaggle and Jupyter Notebook. When you are ready to spare your internet, then Google Collaboratory and Kaggle is okay. If you are not comfortable, you are not having adequate internet infrastructure, then only Jupyter Notebook. Another methodology. Then coming to this introduction, this is the major point you may need to understand. That is why I want to spend few minutes. Packages, we used to call packages. I hope that all of you would be familiar with the C programming. File inclusion, pre-processing section, file inclusion. What is the meaning of file inclusion? Let us first dive into that deeper. That file inclusion is equivalent to these packages. That's it, number one. You would have studied in your first year or somewhere, hash include open bracket stdio.h. Header file inclusion. That header file inclusion only, we are going to tell that here, inclusion of packages, importing packages. These are all the terminologies, technical terminologies people would be using. Nothing to worry about it. Now I come to what is the meaning of package or header files. If you look at C, is being released by Dennis Ritchie in the AT and T Bell laboratories probably 30-40 years ago. I'm not exactly sure about minimum, I'm telling. That language would have been released 30-40 years ago. That 30 years ago, if you look at the machine, how it would be, imagine the machine architecture configuration 30 years ago. what you are enjoying, the recent day kids, what you are enjoying with the mobile was not there. We were working with the machine, not even the performance of your own mobile. Not even up to the mark of your own mobile. That was the scenario. On top of the performance, every laptop or the machine would become huge in size. So those days, if at all, entire compiler need to be brought to the machine, it is not at all possible. It will not fit in. What is the meaning of compiler? I try to tell you. All of you have in your brain English compiler. That is why at least partially what I am speaking, you can be able to understand. What is compiler? During your childhood or later part, you will be learning one language, one English language, Indian language, your mother tongue, father tongue. Then you may be learning foreign languages like French, Italy, some language you will be, Japanese, Chinese, you will be learning some languages, Spanish. Every language while you are learning, you yourself designing a compiler in your brain. Unless otherwise that compiler is exist in your brain, you may not be able to understand whatever the language I speak. All of a sudden, if I start speaking Malayalam right now, how many of you would be able to understand? I'm not sure. Not even 1%. You must have the compiler in your brain in order to understand Malayalam language. Otherwise, the moment I start speaking Malayalam, you cannot understand. Hope you can understand what is the importance of compiler. The same similar manner, compiler installation is essential for the computer. Unless otherwise compiler is installed, you will be telling, no, I need to install Anaconda, I need to install Python. That installation, one step, making your computer to become eligible to understand that language. But a human, we will take 3 years, 4 years to learn one particular language. Not even lifetime is sufficient to learn. But a machine will learn any computer programming language within 5 minutes to 10 minutes. How it is learning within 5 minutes to 10 minutes? Installation. That is a step. Whenever you are, remember, you are doing installation, you are bringing the knowledge of that particular language to your machine. You are installing the compiler to the machine. What is the purpose of installing that compiler? Only then, anything which you speak in that language, machine can understand. If you are committing wrong, then it will give you bug, error report. How it is giving error report? It is trying to understand or trying to translate your written program line by line. Then imagine, whenever you are doing just matrix addition, imagine just matrix addition. How? What is the load of your computer? One is your computer must able to understand what language you have written, how you have written, correct or wrong, what you have written. First, it should understand the language stuff. Subsequently, it needs to work on the logical step. You may be giving 4x4 matrix, then it needs to read one by one, it needs to calculate, something it has to do. So it has two jobs. One is, we also do two jobs. See, if I am trying to tell you, I am going to scold you. Or do you have sense? I am telling. What you are doing, you will be first understanding whether I am speaking rightly or wrong. Then immediately what you will be doing, you want to laugh at me. You will be immediately showing your anger. That is the output. You understood what I am speaking, then you are reacting for that. So we do first try to understand the language. Subsequently, we will take action. Machine is also doing that. Computer machine is almost imitation of human brain. Machine first tries to understand your language. Then it starts working upon the logic which you have mentioned. Then it gives output. Now I am coming to the story called package. Now that entire compiler, if you bring into RAM memory, nowadays everybody familiar with what is RAM. When you buy your mobile, you are very cautious. 4 GB and above only you are buying the RAM mobile nowadays. 2 GB RAM will not suitable for mobile internet applications. Minimum 4 GB RAM is expected for best WhatsApp, video, audio, enjoyment. So for that 4 GB RAM you are expecting. Those days, 2 GB RAM itself very tedious. So that they decided that the entire compiler need to be divided into segments. Entire compiler is divided into parts. Every part is given the freedom to the user. What user is expecting, what intended to do the program, that part alone going to be brought to the compilation time. That is the philosophy called inclusion of the header file or packages, any language. All the modern languages, right from C language onwards, COBOL, Fortran, BASIC, Kiran, Patel, please, yeah. Those are all the language doesn't have the concept called header file inclusion or pre-processing. Right from C language, every language has the capability called pre-processing. Pre-processing means before even going to start our coding, we will be requesting the particular compiler. I want these are all the packages. I'm going to work on something related to this package. So that we no need to worry about RAM capacity. Whatever may be the capacity of the laptop or device, we can concentrate on what exactly we want. That alone we will be bringing. If you look at your C program, at the max you will be bringing 5 header files. stdio.h, conio.h, stringio.h, mathio.h, at the max for the academic programs. If you try to do some kernel related operations functions, you may bring some other header file. Otherwise, you will be basically working with these 4 or 5 packages, header files. When it comes Python, it is package. The name only changed. The philosophy, the functionality, or what way that is sliced, that and all not changed. Now let us go back to Python. Now, what are all the package minimum we may need to be familiar? NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, Scikit-learn, Seaborn. NumPy is for numerical operation. I tell you guys, mechanical, especially most of you are from mechanical, numerical operation with this NumPy, you can do lot of wonder. Most of your assignments you can solve using Python program rather than clicking and pressing your calculator. This NumPy has lot of statistical calculus related packages, probability related packages. Whatever I mentioned, all the mathematical related stuff. If we want to find out...
Kindly share your screen. Few people are asking for that.
Sir, I shared, sir. Already be showing shared. Really, I am going mad with this. Already it is in the present mode shared. Several times I am sharing. Better let us move to Zoom tomorrow. Really, I am fed up. Guys, please tell me, are you comfortable with the Zoom? May I move to Zoom? That is very stable.
Ma'am, somebody is presenting by mistake, means your screen goes off, ma'am.
Yeah, that is a problem. Somebody is trying to pressing the presentation screen, means mine is going. That how can I detect? I am concentrating on flow of presentation. So kindly, I request organizer to move on to Zoom. I'm firmly telling. If at all no Zoom, I'm not ready to continue. I'm reaching my level of patience. Please kindly accept, otherwise I wanted to withdraw. Extreme word I'm using. I'm not comfortable with this Google Meet. It's deteriorating my quality also. Zoom will give good quality of audio, good quality of video, and all the presentation mode. With this note, I wanted to continue. That's it. It's not my mistake. It's not their mistake also. If they don't know about the particular software, they will be exploring. Then every time I need to shift my attention. So it's very tiring process. When it comes Zoom, no one can present. I can mute all also. So numerical operation.
Ma'am, that is a paid software. It is a free software.
Zoom also up to 100 members, it is free. Today I could see 79 members, yesterday 52. 79, up to 100 members, up to 1 hour I can conduct session freely. This is for your information.
No, you are right.
All of us need to download that Zoom app using Google Play Store. If at all you are using mobile, if it is your laptop, you need to download. With that, we can move on. It is free for attendees also, free for presenter also. It accepts maximum 99 candidates, Zoom, for free of cost for 1 hour. Okay. Yeah, let us see. Now NumPy, because it is a strainful job when it becomes technical, if it is like kind of a motivational talk, we no need to worry. Google Meet is fine. It is completely technical. Without showing notebook, nothing I can present. I need to sometime articulate, sometime I need to show the code. Then I need a smooth platform that everyone need to understand. So NumPy is for numerical operation with a couple of lines. At the max with the 4 lines, you can find out determinant of the matrix. With the help of 4 lines, you can find out conditional probability. With the help of 4 lines, it is possible to find out eigenvalue, eigenvector. Most of you might be using, mathematical people would be using, these are all the kind of mathematical notions for your problem solving or for your interpretation or for your project. So this Python will help you. Only with this package you can complete the requirement of mechanical engineering. Coming to Pandas, this is the package helps for reading the data. Excel, you suppose if you want to analyze data of 1 lakh rows, 25 columns, only with the Pandas it is possible to read. Pandas will help always to read the data file. The data file could be text file or Excel file. There are several formats available, JSON file, XML file, that all I will show you later. So all the kind of data manipulation, reading data, writing data to the file back, or fetching particular column upon some condition. I want to pull only the female information from the data set. I want to pull only computer science department people at one end. I want to pull out mechanical also, who are all male. That kind of data I want to pull out. It is possible for segmenting either in terms of column or rows upon conditional expression. We can pull the data, gather, aggregate the data, group the data. We can operate with the data. We can play around with data in simple. So for that, this Pandas package is useful. Next, Matplotlib. This is a package useful for visual plots, sine wave, cos wave, any kind of plot, histogram, frequency count, a cumulative plot, any kind of plots we can do with Matplotlib. Skykit Learn, this is for machine learning. Exactly what we are talking, machine learning, prediction. That prediction or machine learning, the moment we use, the only the hero for machine learning package is Skykit Learn. Learning our data analytics. With respect to data analytics, Skykit Learn is the only hero. Without this package, we cannot do any kind of machine learning analytics or processes. The last one more I am trying to give, that is Seaborn. This is also for plot. Little bit aesthetic, and whichever the plot are not possible in the Matplotlib, those are all have been included into Seaborn. For the plotting, particular plotting purpose, we can use both or either one. This is for machine learning. This is for numerical operation. This is for handling data frames. With this introduction, I am moving on to Python data structure. What is data structure? I will just explain the theoretical notion. Maybe last 10 minutes only we can look at the code, but these are all the foundation required in order to understand the coding. Data structure, list is one of the data structure available, tuple, sets, dictionary, string. Then array, then matrix handling, matrix operations. These are all array, just array. There is no more matrix. With array itself, we can do matrix also. So array is the data type. We can do matrix with that, or single array, or two-dimensional array, or multi-dimensional array. So these are all the data structure. Let me come back to the story. What is data structure? When you are dealing with the computer, anything which we do, one is data or input, another one is the coding. Instructional memory, data memory. There are two memory predominantly working. That RAM, we used to say primary memory. That primary memory itself partitioned into several segment. One is instructional memory or instructional segment. Code memory, they used to call code memory. Then data memory, stack memory, extra memory. Primarily, RAM is categorized into these 4 memory segments. That code memory will hold the code of your program. What exactly user is writing, hello world, you would have written. Sum of 2 numbers, you would have written. Matrix addition, you would have written. That whatever the program you are writing, tiny program, that is kept it in the code memory before the execution, CPU. And data memory will hold all your input and data symbols related to all the data handling. That data memory will hold that. Now coming to the point, what is data structure? How the memory need to be allotted in order to hold the data, holding the data. I'm going to tell you, whenever the moment I'm going to tell you, I am going to donate or gift you 5 kg chocolate. Then what kind of vessel you will be bringing, or the container? You will be bringing container of neat and clean without any bad smell and tightly packed, because your chocolate may melt. So you will be tightly packing. Then you will bring a container suitable to put it in your refrigerator. How do you choose the container? Depending upon what item I am giving, how much quantity I am giving, what is its property, how frequently you will keep using that item. I will come out with one more analogy. I am going to tell you, 5 kg LPG gas I am going to donate you. Immediately, what kind of container? Kerosene. I am going to give you 5 liter kerosene. What kind of container you would be bringing? Very dirty, unused, something damaged. That kind of container. Because once kerosene is poured onto that container, never you can reuse it for any other purpose. Then you will be asking me how much you are going to give. If I give 1 liter, you will bring some waste bottle, water bottle. If I give 2 liter, you will bring Coca-Cola bottle, waste bottle. If I give 5 liter, you need to find out some vessel. If I give you 10 liter, could you get my point what I am telling? So whenever the data is stored in the data memory, we need to understand the type of the data, size of the data, nature of the data, how we are going to operate. If I am giving you rice, every day rice is essential. Or I am going to give you wheat flour. Every day wheat flour is essential. Then what kind of container you will bring? Frequently, whenever which you use the container. It should be easy to open. It should be easy to close. You will keep very near to the gas or kitchen accessories. You want to keep it in the refrigerator or on the left. So these are all the 4 parameters. Keep it in your mind. The moment data structure anyone says, what is the type of the data we are going to store? What is the size of the data we are going to store? Size of the memory reservoir. Then what is the type and scope of the data, or how frequent we are going to use? Based on these all the parameters within the computer, we need to choose the memory location in order to store the data. That's all. Depending upon that category, list is one of the data structure. Tuple is one of the data structure. Sets, dictionary, string, array. These are all the data structure one is expected to be thorough on before going to data scientist, before becoming a data scientist. This is minimum requirement. Now let us go to coding section for another 10-15 minutes. First variable, one by one assignment I am doing. Second variable. Variable 1, I am giving the value 10. Variable 2, I am giving the value 3.14. Variable 3, I am giving Python. You can give either double quotation or single quotation. Now, first stands for integer assignment. Second stands for float and string. Now, I want to print combinedly. This is a kind of printing more than one variable value. Look at here. Variable 1, I am giving comma. Single quotation, I am giving. That gives a space between two variable. Or else I can give something here also. Demo, I am giving demo. Here I am giving mic. Whatever I am giving in the quotation, it just prints. See, after 10, it prints me demo. Then variable 2, it prints 3.14. Then subsequently, it displays or prints mic. Then it gives variable 3. We used to give, now the result of addition of two number is. We used to give some explanation, some demonstration through English. For that, this kind of thing. You can even prefix with, see, single quotation, the beginning. Single quotation, I'm closing, comma. I'm going to execute once again. Look at the beginning, 10, demo, 3.16, mic, Python. So this is the kind of complex information printing, we can say. Printing more than one variable or mixed data type. If you look at C, it is very tedious. You should know always cautious about what is the data type of each variable. You need to bring appropriate format specifier. In Python, there is no worry. What you want to print, how you want to print, you need to focus on those two. I want to print with the beginning 10 demo 3.14 make Python. That's it. Now assigning same value to multiple variable. Yesterday one of you raised this question, so that yesterday itself it has been covered. Now print variable 1 space variable 2, similar to the previous line. We are trying to print all the three variables using one print command. Subsequently, this is for multiple variable assigning multiple data types, multiple values. Variable 1 becomes integer, variable 2 becomes float, 3 becomes Python. That's it. Now coming to, this is much more important, slicing operator. Hope up to this all of you would be clear. Now I move on to slicing operator. Look at slicing operator. I am creating str as one of the variable. Otherwise, string also I can give, string. I am giving hello world. No, I can't change it. Then everywhere I need to update. Str, I am assigning the value hello world. Hello guys, anything. This is a complete string. Look at the very first statement. I am printing str alone. It prints hello world completely. Second line, print str of 0. What is the meaning is, whenever I am giving the value, it has memory indexing. If you look at the colonies, even house, if you look at any state or any location, we have a door number. Why the door number? In order to identify, recognize easily, courier man, postman used to look at your door number and deliver those postal deliveries. So for that, this kind of numbering system is important. Similarly, when you look at RAM, it will look like a colony. If you look at doctor's colony, quarters, the entire quarters, lawyers colony, police colony, if you look at that colony will be having one by one. It will look like similarly colony-like. Then where exactly it stores? For that, one identification number. That identification number is termed as index. That's it. Now we are going back. Now H is having holding. H will hold the index number 0. The index number starts from 0. That we should remember. That's it. Then E would become 2, 1, L would become 3, sorry, 2. Another L would become 3, O would become 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. The space is also considered. This is 5. Then W will become 6, O would become 7, R would become 8, 9, 10, 11. That's it. So totally 11 indexes. That we need to remember. Now I am particularly asking the 0th location to be printed. So that I am giving 0, it prints me H. Because in the 0th index, H is available. Look at next. Print str of, this is slicing operator. So far now I haven't introduced slicing operator. Just now I am introducing. 2 to 5 I am trying to tell. Character from 3rd position to 5th element. 2 means 3rd. 0, 1, 2, 3. Now from this 0, 1, 2, this 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, LLO it will give. Yeah, it is giving LLO. The next is 2 colon. I am telling only the beginning of the string to be displayed. I am not ending with where exactly I want to stop. So that what it does, 0, 1, 2, it starts from first L and it displays the remaining all. Double LO, world. Next, look at that other vice versa option. I am not mentioning the beginning, rather I am mentioning the end. Then naturally it should start from the 0th index, it should stop at 2. Then where it is 2? 0, H is 0, 1, 2, hell. Hell would become the, not the hell, it is giving H, 1 minute, 2. 2 means 0, 1, 2. Yeah, it is taking before 2. Why before 2? I'll tell you. Whenever the ranging operator or slicing operator we are giving, last mentioned item, a mentioned value, minus 1 it will consider. Minus 1, normally it used to consider. So what we are trying to tell here, starting from 0 and before 2 it should end. So that 0, 1. Next is colon. No specification, no beginning, no ending, so that it gives just hello world. Next, str into 2. There is no literal multiplication will happen. Other language, whenever you are using this arithmetic operator with the string operations, it will give throw error. Whereas with Python, it will not give error. If at all we are trying to multiply with the number upon string data type, it will just repeat hello world, hello world. Similarly for the plus operation also, whatever we say before and after the plus, it will become the concatenation operator. It just combines and it prints. You just play around with this slicing operator. You need to give like this, then play with the number, with this range specification. Easily you can able to understand. Nothing big, toughest job in data. Do you have any doubts so far with this slicing operator? Now I move on to one more. Let me look at chat box. Guys, if you have any doubts, you can communicate here. Slicing operator alone. Yeah, nice that somebody have given definition for data science. Waiting for chocolates. Okay, data structure is a collection of data value, relationship among them. That is very formal definition. So that, I give you number later on. Fine. I request you to join in the WhatsApp group. Mr. Karnakaran Subraj is keep on sharing. He's one of the admin of this group. So I request, other than Synergy Institute of Technology, those who are taking part in this session for all the 5 days, make use of this WhatsApp group so that I can communicate with you anything to be changed in the near sessions. So with that, we continue. If you have any doubts, please ping me in the chat box related to especially slicing operator. Then after slicing operator, we will move on to the next discussion. This is called reverse string using slicing. I'm just declaring NS1 variable. I love Python programming. What I am doing here, double slicing operator I am doing. Continuously I am giving colon colon minus 1. This is the syntax. Why you are giving, you can't question me. What it would do is, it will start printing this character, this order, right to left order. That's all. Just you want to reverse anything which is assigned or available in the variable. Either you can get input or you can assign something. Then it will print. Yesterday one of you asked a question, how to get input? Yeah, I forgotten. Because of data science, never use input. I will give you the function input. See, it is asking me to enter. If I give 45, A will become integer. If I give 45.5, A will become float. See, 45. Could you get my point? Input function, simple input function I'm introducing. I will introduce the complex input function little bit later. Now one more I'm going to show you input function. Yeah. Now B is equal to input of double quotation, enter the name. So it is asking enter the name. Now I can give enter my name. Just after giving my name, that's all. Output also coming. This is how you need to give input. Yesterday someone asked. Now I am going to give B is x is equal to int of, listen or pay your attention here little bit, input of, I am going to give input. Now here enter the number I am going to give. Over. Look at carefully. I am first getting the input with the display text. This is called display text. It is going to ask enter the number and I am going to convert it into int. Look at what I am doing. See, 55.789. What I am trying to give? Float value. Giving while entering, I am giving float value. Then before giving to assigning to x, the prime duty of this command is to convert it into int. See, invalid letter for int with base 10, something it is giving, int. Something, 1 minute. int of not int, not int is not possible. Float I need to do. Why? I will tell you. Float. 1 minute. Enter. Yeah. Whatever you are entering in this input function, everything is treated as a string. Please remember and understand. Everything will be treated as a string. Whatever you enter into this. So that integer is not possible to convert whenever I am giving 45.5 this something. Float it is taking. It is converting it into float. I will come out with other complex shortly. Today I am just introducing introduction to int. How to get input. So this plain input if you give, whatever you are entering, there will not be any problem. It just accepts. Similarly, you can give some display text. With that display text, it is possible to give any information, anything, integer, float or anything. Then converting one data type to another data type is a point of discussion here. Whatever you are feeding to input, always it accepts only in terms of string. Although it looks like 45, it would be string. Wait a minute, I will check it out. I need to type A. It will tell me, see, look at str. It gives me str. Similarly, B also, let me check. This is naturally str because the input itself Lakshmi. So that type of, 1 minute, what is happening? Type of B, enter, str. Now, let me print X. X, it gives me float. Because I have converted explicit type conversion. So far now we have seen string to float conversion. Given input will be available in the form of string. We are converting it into float. So the value is 56.6. So with that note, we are moving on to the first data structure which we have listed here. That first data structure is list. This data structure we are going to touch upon for another 5 minutes. Then we will wind up. Always remember, I'll just give a little bit annotation. List always looks like this. Whenever you are seeing anything in terms of square bracket, remember that is list. Square bracket is list. Or else you can use the word list. That is very complex, no need to worry. Now I'm going to give A is equal to empty open bracket. That signifies I'm creating an empty list. That's it. Now let us see. L1 is the list name. You can keep anything. It's a kind of variable. I'm going to create a list of element within the square bracket 1 to 4. L2 is another list name. I'm going to create the square bracket with list of 4 other element. Now L1 hold these 4. L2 hold these 4. Now your question would be, what is the data type of list? No need to worry of data type. It will allow mixed data type also. If I want, I can change this 60 in terms of 6.99. 7, I can change in terms of 788. I can collect list of elements. Temporarily, let me delete this all because there is a purpose of explanation. Later on, I will show. Collection of different data type, heterogeneous data type. You can put it together in list. That is the beauty of list. List of element, it doesn't matter what we are trying to give. Here there is no homogeneity. In your first year you used to study array is for homogeneous representation of element. That is not here. List will allow any data type, any number of element, mixed also, homogeneous also, heterogeneous also. If you look at L1 is homogeneous list of item. All are integer type. Of this data, I am naming it as, there is no technical concept. For the explanation purpose, I am trying to tell you, L1 is a homogeneous list of item. L2 is also a homogeneous list of item of the type integer. That's it. Now let us see. L1 into 3, it does the operation automatically upon 1, 2, 3, 4, and it executes. Now I will create more cells for demonstration. I'm going to copy paste this code and L13. So I need to execute this first. I haven't executed. That is why error. See, look at it, repeats 1, 2, 3, 4. it repeats three times. This is how it does. It won't do multiplication of each and every element with three. It won't do. It does repetition of the list of items. This is the first understanding. Next, when we do L1, L2, what it does? Insert below. Next, I am copying L1 and L2. Let us see. It just concatenates. Don't assume that it is going to take one by one element, it is going to do operation, because that is not possible, that is not permitted. Why? Because the beginning itself I had given you clue. List will allow heterogeneous data type, so that none of the operation is suitable for that core nature of the list data type. Star means if it is homogeneous, then that kind of star would perform on literal multiplication. Now, since the property of list is mixed data type, star is doing the repetition operation, plus is doing concatenation operation. This is what I want to mention here. Star is for repetition, plus is for concatenation. Now let us look into next instruction. Watch the instruction. In is called membership function, not in in. There are two membership functions are available. I give you here annotation. Yeah.
I think yes, we should wind up the session. It's already crossed.
Yeah. With that, with these two lines, I will complete. That's what I said. With that cell itself, I thought of completing. 10 in L1. List L1. Sorry, 100 in L1. 100 is available in L1 or not is the question we are asking to the computer. Look at L1 doesn't have 100. Now, what it is going to do, let us see. I'm going to copy here. 100 in L1, false. Why it is giving false boolean value? Because 100 is not available in L1. Whereas next one, 4 in L1. Look at 4 is available. Let us see what would be the output. With that, I will stop. Look at here, it gives true. In is called membership function. It gives me the value true. That's all. With that, today, introduction to list we have learned, slicing operator we have learned, input function we have learned, print function, complex print function we have learned, how to reverse a string we have learned, subsequently little bit of operations on list we have seen, and membership function. We have seen the membership function in, that's all. With that note, if any of you have doubts, you please post here. Collection of string data type. Amuda madam, it is possible to have collection of string data type also. I request all of you to join in this WhatsApp group. I am also available for any kind of conversation. You can communicate. L1 into L2, it won't accept. I think so it will give error because not possible. It is not defined. I will perform here L1 into L2. Except the QA session, I'm not going to do anything. See, it gives error, not possible. Because L1, L2, not because of that heterogeneous nature only, it is not possible. Few of you asked my number. You join this WhatsApp group, naturally you can get connected. That's all.
Okay, anyone having any question, please?
So L1, L2 is not permitted. So how to delete the cell? Edit, delete the cell. Yeah, guys, if you have any questions, you can open up here. Otherwise, we can wind up.
Abhishek,
ma'am, why it didn't convert? The way to represent the function is not right. Tomorrow, I will show you for the appropriate
ma'am,
conversion.
Ma'am, 56.66 treated as
integer. But integer to int, it is not converting. Maybe I think so. Integer, I need to put instead of int. I try now. That function, I'm not remembering. That is instantly I had brought, no, wait a minute, I will do here, y is equal to integer of, that is what your doubt, so that I want to clarify you, input of question mark, enter the number, integer itself not available. Int. I will work it out and I will come out tomorrow. Int. It gives me 56.6. Enter. It accepts but it gives error. Base 56.5. Tomorrow I will come out with this right function for that.
Ma'am, Ma'am,
Yeah,
just
list all
one
three
by
in
one,
slicer.
ma'am.
Tomorrow we are going to look at Subrat Kumar. List slicing also tomorrow we can look at. List slicing and the input conversion to the integer. These two tomorrow I'll give you. Yeah, float, it is not at all float. Anushman, that actually it is a string data type. From string to float only we have converted, not float to float. I said, see, type function I have given you now, look at. After input function, everywhere I used type. Look at here, input 45, type A. For although it looks like normal 45, what is the data type? String, str. Next, enter the name, B. Enter the name, then data type str. Whereas third one, explicitly I have converted whatever the string data type into float data type. It accepts. Integer also it is possible. I need to find out the right command. Tomorrow I will come out with that. X. Now it is converting, although 56.6 is treated as string initially, it has been converted into float. Understand? Yeah. If I write print a string of 2:13, what will be the result? Beyond the index, if you go, it will give you index error, out of boundary error. Within that, what to say, hello world count, within that count, if you mention, it will start from the index 0. Sorry, it will start from the index 2. From 2 to 13, it will move on. 2 to 12, because never it will consider up to the last specification, up to 13. It will end up with 12 because we are starting the index value 0. Because of the 0 starting, always the ending value will be considered with minus 1. That is what I have written on the notebook itself. See, in the slicing operator, last mentioned value, delimiter. This is called delimiter. Delimiter always considered with minus 1. This is the answer for you. Yeah, with that note, see you all. Already many of the members left. If you have any doubt, you can drop. Otherwise, I can sign off. Bye, all of you. Thank you. Let us meet tomorrow by 5 o'clock. Yeah, thank you all. Good night.
Thank you, ma'am. Good night.
Yeah, see you guys. Bye, all of you. Thank you, Abdul. Bye.